Coach Tom Coughlin. Tom, welcome. Good to see you.
Hi, Mike. Thank you.
Any change, Tom? Any different feel being here and not being in Albany this year?
Well, the idea that, we're at home. We have all our facilities here. We teach from these teaching rooms, from these instruction units. We have all of our media facilities here. We're in HD now, which is a wonderful thing. So that aspect of it, we're on our own fields, so on and so forth. It is a training camp, but obviously, Mike, it's an adjusted camp because of the new CBA. We can only practice one time a day, so the two-a-day situation is gone. You have to really do a great job with your jog-throughs because, really, what I tell our players, your second practice is your jog-through in the evening. So you've got to get the maximum out of it. We have extended so that we're in the meeting rooms longer. We jog through right before the one practice that we have a day. Then we come back in the evening, we review the tape, and then we go on the field for corrections, which amounts to our second practice. So all of that takes place. Now, the one thing we do have, Mike, and we've had probably four, believe it or not, times where we've had to go inside with the rain. We have our indoor facility, which has really, really provided us. It's eliminated an awful lot of anxiety when you are waiting with the idea that weather's on its way, trying to decide, where and how you're going to practice. So that has been a huge relief for us to be able to go into the facility inside.
Tom, you've had the old world training camps, now the new world training camps. Two things jump out. One, getting the new players and the rookies up to speed. Very difficult, right?
Very difficult. Very difficult because you don't even get them until the middle of April. We've changed that as well. So the idea that a lot of these kids that used to be around all winter, which was a very good thing, not only for them but for us, because they were constantly being met with, they were constantly being taught individual stuff, shown tape by the coaches, that's no longer available to us. So an awful lot of things are crammed into one, and you sit there and you watch your practices go by and you become impatient about getting better. You really do. And, you're constantly sitting there saying to yourself, gosh, when is this going to happen? When is it going to happen?
The other is the idea, and you hear this league-wide, a lot of people feel because there's such a lack of contact that maybe it's not getting these players ready for games and maybe we're having more injuries because of that. How do you feel about that?
Well, I don't know that is a fact as of yet. I think that it's going to take some time to figure all of that stuff out. I do know this, is that whereas when you were going 2-1-2 like that, you had some flexibility in there that you could examine the fact that they were tired and you might, take the pads off them one time. This is a whole different deal. You know, you're saying to yourself, I have to really do a great job structuring in my shelled practices because you've got to get them ready, the shoulders, the constant contact, the idea that when you're tired, you still have to play your way through it. Those are the things that are being investigated. Now, quite frankly, Mike, there's an awful lot of science coming into the game as well, not only nutrition, but also the way in which we practice, how hard they work, the information that comes forth from some scientific studies that have been done that we might project where we are in terms of a practice, what kind of effort we're getting, whether we need to back off a little bit or can we go harder the next time.
And if you're a team, and there's very few teams this way anymore, but if you're a team that really is a running team, very hard to get your running game up to speed because you just don't get a lot of chance to go out there and work on your running game.
No, you don't. You really don't. And that is an issue, and stopping the run as well, because of the nature of how you practice and the way in which you have to practice.
Before I get to the team itself, a little with you. This is your 10th year with the Giants. The only coach who ever coached longer here was Steve Owens. Also, this is now your longest stop. 10 years is a lifetime in the NFL. I went and looked. I said, is this time not longer than Jacksonville? It's 1 year longer than Jacksonville. Yeah. Now, I went and looked. So 10 years is a very long time. Some people say 10 now like 20 used to be. It's hard to last 10 years in one place. Does it feel like 10 years here?
It really doesn't for me. It's been an exciting 10 years for sure.
Sure. Great 10 years, yeah.
And I've enjoyed every, to be honest with you, almost every minute of it. And I don't look at it that way, and I'm certainly not counting years or anything of that nature. The excitement is, when it comes time, the excitement is there. The idea camp, summer's over, let's go. you know, my wife stands at the door and, you know, here's your hat, that kind of deal. Let's get to it. So those type of things are there for me. And the excitement, the competitiveness, the division, you know, the great competition within our division, those things are all very, very important to me.
All right. This year's team, just yesterday there was talk about getting this Giant defense back to being a Giant defense where you've got some bigger guys now. And also just basically sending a message that you're going to be a typical Giant defense this year.
Right. Trying to be a physical defensive football team that does stop the run and does create opportunities for ourselves. You know, the idea last year we had a tremendous number of turnovers and those type of things. And I, you know, we mentioned to our team, you know what, stop the run and see how that goes. You may be even able to create some more.
How about not having a JPP? Do you have to just say we don't know when? Do you have an idea on him? I mean, where is his status?
Well, we're
right
going to get him, no question. I mean, he's really, really coming along. He's done everything that the medical people have asked him to do. I see great progress. I see the look in his eye again. You know, he hasn't been able to take advantage of any of this, which obviously everybody needs, and we're going to have to be very careful as we work him back in, but it's just a matter of time.